think Disney, Walt Disney, theme song from a movie. Beauty and the Beast, yes. How many of you knew that? Beauty and the Beast? Okay. A very knowledgeable audience, yes. Now, when you listen to that, you heard, if you were real careful, you heard from the very beginning the melody kind of to where you could recognize it. It was a different style because it was the Count Basie style. But, you know, and it was swinging like crazy, you know, it was doing that, and everybody was together, but in harmonies. And then it got a little further along, and then you started hearing things coming in. You say, where did that come from? And so on and so forth, and all kinds of stuff going on in there. And then you hear Nathan playing a tenor solo, and it was improvisation, and he was making it up right here. And so you heard all of that, and then it kind of came down soft, and then it melt up. And well, you know, that was a great arrangement because the band loves to play it, because it's difficult, first of all, and it's just swings really well. So that's what I'm talking about. You can sing Beauty and the Beast if you want to do that, and then you can notice that the melody was changed, the style was changed, the rhythms were changing, instrumentation was going all over the place, you had an ad-lib solo and all that. So that's jazz. That's creating a different type of music and a different idea of what that song probably was meant to be, you know. But it was really nice. So anyway, good for you for knowing that. And I want to have Nathan stand up right here. And I want Nathan stand up because he just not too long ago became a doctor, a medical doctor. Yeah. And I'm really mad at him because, first of all, he's going to leave us, but secondly, he's going to Florida, so you can't be too upset, right? Okay, but we're going to miss him, but he's always welcome to come and play with us, but he'll be with us for a few more gigs. Okay, thank you, Nathan. And, all right, page two. I had to write this all out because I start hemming and hawing and aying and everything else if I don't. So I kind of like to do that right now. The next song, I don't think you'll recognize this because it was written by Vince Norman for the Army Jazz Ambassadors in 2009. Did anybody hear them when they came through at Missouri State? They actually did a concert right here. That's the big Army jazz group from Washington. Did you? They were phenomenal, weren't they? And this was one of the tunes that they played. And so I heard these, and then they were available for nothing if you just get on the internet, because they allow that to happen. And they just want to spread their music and help educationally, help bands and high school bands, college bands, and everything else. So we really appreciate folks like that are willing to give up their arrangements. So this one is called Celestial Swingin' Blues. Don't know, but we'll feature several solos on this, and I'll introduce them to you after we're finished here. But anyway, in fact, we've got a couple of things that were written for the Jazz Ambassadors because they really had some nice arrangements. Okay, Celestial, what did I say it was? Swingin' Blues, yeah. Thank you. You just looked at the internet?
Yes, I did, but I thought I knew it, so I took it on.
Oh, okay. Now, I'm listening to her because that's my wife. She keeps me in line. Okay. We did have a new soloist on that. That was Ron Walker, right here. Ron, stand up. Yeah. All right. Find your bone player. Okay.
My soul is completely unintentional, Bob. I just couldn't wait to start playing.
Oh, okay. Did you have a solo?
Yeah, I wasn't written in there, but I started. Oh.
See, this is jazz. This is jazz. It's creating. We just create our own things. Yeah, that's great. Well, we'll forgive you because you play so many things right. Yeah. Okay. Now, this next one is I think, well, I don't know if it's their favorite. It's my favorite. Well, I have several favorites, but this is one of them. And this one is a Beatles tune. I'm not going to tell you the name of it because you'll recognize it, I think. But boy, does it change. This has really changed to make it jazz wise, you know. I mean, the Beatles, you know, were great, and they did their thing real well, but I'm not sure they knew a whole lot about jazz. But this is jazzed up pretty well, and we're going to feature, on this next one, we're going to feature Ron again on trombone and Nathan on tenor sax, because they have a lot of duets in theirs, and they play the melody, so listen for it if you haven't figured it out yet. And you're going to hear all kinds of stuff, including a classical style fugue in the middle of it. So you'll have to listen real carefully because it starts in the piano, and then it just goes with Jesse on bass. He does play some right notes there. And then it just continues going on and adding things. I mean, it's just a kick to play. It's also very difficult. So, you know, enjoy. You'll get to tell me what the name of it is later.
Sorry.
Thank you.
shout it out.
Eleanor Rigby.
Absolutely. Eleanor Rigby. Yeah. And you can actually find that quite a bit in there, you know, if you really listen to it. But
it was made rhythmically, and they changed the melody line somewhat and whatever. Then it got really wild in there, didn't it? Yeah. The improvisation was off the wall, so that was really neat. Eleanor Rigby, and we're going to go to another, and that was a Jazz Ambassador tune also that was written by a guy named Eric Richards in 2012. So they didn't play it on that particular day, but they were here. I'd like to feature our lead alto player now, Ben Huggins, and you've heard him play a little earlier on the, I think on the first tune we did, on a very well-known composition, which you will be able to tell us what that is. It was from a, from a musical show by George Gershwin, and it's called Porky and Bess. And so we're going to feature him on this. And again, this is one of my arrangements, but again, I made it so that it changed style a little bit. It doesn't change the melody a lot, but it gives him some improvisation time. So that's another one of those things we changed it around a little bit. But I think you'll enjoy the song, because it's one of the neatest ones I think I've ever heard. And it actually, if you're a musician, you know what I'm talking about, I think most of you are. It starts out in 6/8 time, if you know what 6/8 time is, and so it has kind of a flowing thing that kind of bluesy, you know. And Summertime was pretty bluesy. Gershwin wrote a lot of that. So anyway.
Thank you.
got just a couple left for you. This one now, I know some of you are very, very familiar with the 1940s music, and you like to hear it. We like to play it also, but this is going to be a little different. This arrangement is by that gentleman, Sammy Nestico, that I talked about, that was Count Basie's arranger. And there's three tunes in this song, so we call it a medley. And these three tunes are very recognizable songs, at least two of them are, from that era of the 1940s. But he changed it a lot. And so you're going to hear some really interesting things going on. And you may not like it. I don't know if you're an avid 1940s person and you don't want to hear anything other than that melody. You're not going to like this. But really, it shows you what jazz does to songs. Simple songs like, you know, some of the things that you listen to, Glenn Miller and so on and so forth. Beautiful dance tunes. You know, they were for dancing. That was the popular tunes of the day. The top 40, you know. But this gentleman got a hold of these and made them something up to date a little bit more. And it's kind of interesting. So anyway, I'm going to ask you about the three tunes, and you tell me what they are. You people that know 1940s and 50s music, you'll know these tunes, and you will be able to recognize them somewhat. Okay? All right. This is called Big Band. What's it called? Big Band Milestones. Okay, something like that. And so here we go. Good luck.
Thank you.
finances like I have, it's hard to kind of understand what's going on there. But the first tune, I think everybody pretty well knew that, at least of the older ages a little bit, you know. What was that? String of Pearls. String of Pearls it was. Yeah. Okay, that was Glenn Miller. Yeah. Okay, the middle one, I don't know if you know it or not, but it was a Count Basie tune. Anybody know it? Little Darlin'. Who said that? All right, you get a star. A gold star for that. Little Darlin', that was written by Neil Hefti, who wrote a lot for Count Basie's band back in the 50s and maybe the 60s. Okay, and the last one was, well, something like that, but that wasn't the title. Anybody know? Okay, nobody knows. Or you don't want to say because you're afraid you'll be wrong. We're all friends here. No one in the mood. Okay. Opus 1. Opus 1. No, that's not one of the most common ones, but it is. It was played a lot, and that was Tommy Dorsey. That was one of his big hits. Okay, so we got a gold star over there and a few other silver stars. All right. Good. We're going to play one more for you, so, but I want to say a few things before we do that. And I'll find my place. Okay, you try to find, people ask me, where can we hear big band music? Well, you can hear big band music here, and you can hear it at various places, because we do about 7 concerts a year, and we'll play different things like Founders Park, and we'll play for the Botanical Garden series in October. We play out there on that little stage out there, and we play some other concerts. So kind of keep your eye on the Weekend Edition maybe, or listen to the station that plays big band music and dance music and so on and so forth, because they help us out by talking about it. But you can also hear it with a group called Wings of Swing, and we have several people in here that are in Wings of Swing, our piano player over here, but she plays saxophone and slide music stand and all kinds of things. I don't know what they are. And Jesse has played with Wings of Swing, and Zach has played with Wings of Swing. We just got a lot of swingers in this group, actually. And Carl Yendez plays lead trumpet with it, and Jim Shannon plays in the group, and Ron Walker plays trombone in the group, and Ivan Ben has played with us some. And if I missed anybody, I'm sorry. But it's a really good band, and they play a lot of dance-type things and banquets and things like that. But that's a pro group that goes out and plays really nice arrangements, too, as a vocalist and everything. So if you ever hear Wings of Swing, well, I play in the group, too, I should say. I play trombone. But anyway, that's another group, Mojo. Mojo is a very fine big band, pro players. Randy Hamm runs the group, and they perform on Tuesdays, the first and third Tuesdays of the month, out at, what's the name of that place?
Crave.
C-R-A-V-E, over on Lindstone. Okay. Okay. Great. And then they have some combo things on alternate Tuesdays of some of the same musicians. They're really, really good. And then there's the Drury University Jazz Orchestra plays a couple of concerts a year. You could probably see something about that. Go on their website. Missouri State University has, I don't know, 3 or 4 jazz ensembles. Do they? You know? Yeah. And they play free concerts at Missouri State. And Evangel University, I've heard their jazz orchestra, and they're very fine. And they bring in guest artists sometimes that are top grade. So there is big band music going on here. You just have to kind of search for it, you know. Sometimes we don't get publicity real well, but it's the way it is. Okay, so take advantage of those things. And before we play our last number, I'd just like to acknowledge our fine rhythm section, because they're the ones that keep us together, and they're the ones that drive us, and they're playing constantly. So they're exhausted right now. I want you to know that. Now, that's Julia, all right? Julia, Julia, I'm sorry, Sutton. I started to say Sellers, but I didn't think you two were married, so I didn't know. Okay, Sutton, Julia, Sutton, and Jesse Owsley. All right, plays our bass. Plays with some different styles of groups. You play in what, about 250 different groups or something? But quite a few anyway, yeah. Zach Sienkowski on drums right here. Yeah. And Steve Joyce back there in the back. Okay. So I think what I'd like to say is just thank you for being here. And we've got one more for you. And I'm going to tell you what it is, because I don't want to stop and say, hey, who knows that song? We're just going to play it, and I think you'll enjoy it. It's just a fun arrangement, and it was written for the Maynard Ferguson Band. And so we'll be featuring Jim on trumpet, Jim Shannon. And I want to thank you so much for being a nice audience, for getting here early, and hearing our warm